Hello and welcome to Totally Scale Models. My name's Steve and in this video I'm going to show you my completed build of the MPC Space 1999 Eagle Transport. Great kit, I've enjoyed doing it, so let's take you down to the bench and show you the completed build. So here she is, finally completed. Been a great kit. Really enjoyed doing this one. And I was inspired to get this by Fox, model making guru. I watched him do his build series a while back now. Did it this year? I can't remember. But I bought it last year at Telford and got it for a bargain. Really good bargain, actually. Well, I thought it was anyway. And yeah, just really pleased with it. It's gone together really well. Nice kit. Few seam lines and stuff like that, but nothing untoward to get rid of. Bit of sand in here and here and there. And yeah, this is the limited edition version, which had all the extra decals, etc. You can tell all these different bits and all the different shadings. Yeah, a hell of a lot of decals. I think that was one of the things that took so long on this, is all the decals that had to be done. But no, I am really pleased with it. It's gone together really well. excuse me. I put some lighting in it. Not strictly Canon, because we've got the blue flickery lighting in the rear, but I liked it. I like it. It's my model, I'll do what I like of it. But yeah, really pleased with it. And then I put some orange lights in the cockpit area. Yeah, so I hope you will like it. But yeah, here it is in all the detail. Very good kit. If you ever think of if you're in 2 miles about getting this kit, I really would. And if you can get the limited edition one, really I would recommend it, because these extra decals are worth it. They do really make it pop. You could spend a lot of time maybe masking and spraying, maybe, I'm not sure. It is advertised for over £200 on some places. I didn't pay that. I paid half that, I think. But yeah, I am very pleased with it. Just very pleased with it. I did use Fox's idea on the engine bells, which I've covered in a couple of videos. I'm just going to turn the light off now so you can maybe see the lighting. Oh, I need to just turn a couple of other ones off as well. 1 second. Yeah, I'm going to have to keep the main ones on above. But yeah, so we can see this is probably going to go out of focus, but you know, there you go. You know, but if we look at that, I think that's quite smart. You've got the pilots in there. I can just about see them. And yeah, I am pleased with this. And then if we just turn it around and see the flickering engines. Like I say, it's not strictly Canon, because what come out of them, out of these engines in the show, was CO2. What else was good about? So I've put all the underneath the switch for the lights is just under there. You might just be able to see it. I've tried to disguise it as best I can, but so I'm gonna turn the lights back on again. So this is gonna go on the shelf. I know one thing I have to do, which I haven't done actually, I do need to give this a flat clear coat, which I haven't done actually, so I must do that before I put it anywhere else. But yeah, very pleased with it. I'm gonna put it up into, I've made a sort of temporary lighting booth with a black background tongue twister and take some pictures. I thought the pictures aren't going to come up that great because I went away camping just recently and managed to break my phone somehow. No one needs to know how. I was just handed my phone. There you go, Dad, there's your phone. Broken. So I have not been able to use the camera on that. That had a decent camera. It was an iPhone with the 4K camera on it. So the pictures I'm going to be taking are going to be taken with my iPad, which is a few years old. So the camera's not going to be great. But it's the best I can do for the time being. So thanks very much for watching. Enjoy the pictures, hopefully. And hopefully I'll see you on my next build. Right, so thanks for watching. Hopefully got the pictures uploaded and some other bits and pieces showing how this went. I must admit I was pretty poor on doing the videoing. I'm going to try and do a lot more videoing of making stuff when I'm building stuff and then try editing it out. I might take Paul Bretland's idea of just filming and then voicing over the top of it. Might come out well, I don't know. Like my struggle to speak sometimes, like that sort of thing, but we'll see. I'm hoping to get some videos going out fairly regularly. I think it's something I need to do, so I've actually made a schedule of stuff of what I need to do. I'm currently doing Paul Bretland again, Paul fanboy, no, Paul Bretland's muscle car build, which I'm doing the Mustang. I've sprayed it in his colour. And I need to 2 clear it, which 2K clear it, and I'm a bit about that. I need to look into how to do that, and never done 2K before because I've never really done built cars before. This will be my first plastic car kit I've ever done. We know we've done the big Mustang, but obviously that's a die cast metal kit, which you don't need to do any painting at all. Just I did a few little bits and pieces, but nothing major. So yeah, so hopefully that will do a progress one on that in a week's and a half time, just over a week's time maybe. But please, in the meantime, give us a like, give us a subscribe, that would be really appreciated, and click on the little bell for any notifications of uploads coming up. Anyway, see you soon. Bye for now.